So we were talking of pelvic spaces, anterior cul-de-sac and posterior cul-de-sac. Why is anterior and why is posterior? Question: Is anterior cul-de-sac exactly anterior to the posterior cul-de-sac? Yes or no? I'm repeating the question. Is anterior cul-de-sac exactly anterior to the posterior cul-de-sac? And if no, why? I need one answer. If, put it here. Yeah. So if it is no, then why so? This is very important when you are doing the ultrasound. This is very important. So the point here is that first raise your hand.
Is there anybody who wants to discuss this point with me? Raise your hand. You have to raise your hand. So let us keep this session more interactive. Dr. Shahina, we are sending you the unmute invitation. So accept this. So whosoever has raised the hand, we are sending the unmute invitation. On accepting the unmute invitation, they have to say hello. Galaxy S9 Plus, this is what is reflecting me over here. Sending you the unmute invitation. Accept it. And quickly say hello. Say hello.
Hello.
Yeah. What is your name, ma'am?
Dr. Anjana Rathi.
Dr. Anjana, is anterior cul-de-sac exactly anterior to posterior cul-de-sac? Yes or no?
No.
No. Why?
No idea.
Why?
It's no.
Then why is that? These points are very important when you are doing ultrasound. When you are doing ultrasound, you should be a half anatomist also. Is my screen coming? Shit. See. Dr. Anjana, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Now see, I will show you this thing on screen.
Fine.
Right now, see, this is the posterior cul-de-sac. Are you seeing this?
Yeah.
Now, where is the anterior cul-de-sac? Let me go here. Yeah. This is the posterior cul-de-sac. Posterior cul-de-sac is in between the rectum and the uterus. Right or wrong?
Right.
This is anterior cul-de-sac. Yes or no?
Yes, this is anterior pouch of Douglas.
This is, I am again repeating my statement. This is posterior cul-de-sac. Can you see the arrow?
Yeah.
Now this is anterior cul-de-sac. I may be right, I may be wrong. Yes or no?
This is not anterior. This is lower down. That is the anterior
cul-de-sac. Why is anterior then? Should I move it up or down?
This up. Is downward. This pouch of Douglas is on downward direction.
What is there? What is here? In anterior to urinary bladder. This is urinary bladder. This is the pubic symphysis. What is there?
These are the muscles.
No. In between the pubic symphysis and the bladder. Which space is this?
Little, I forgot the anatomy right now. I can't recall.
This is space of Ribsis. Okay, I'm giving you a clue. This is space of Ribsis. Now, question. If there will be fluid in peritoneum, that will be in the posterior cul-de-sac, that can go into the anterior cul-de-sac. And now the question, if there is very, very severe fluid, it can even go in the space of Ribsis. Yes or no?
Yes.
No.
No. Oh.
And if no, why? Now see, this is the point. Now see, here, this is the peritoneum coming over here. This is the peritoneum. You are a pedicologist. Yes, Dr. Anjana?
Yeah.
You are every day, not every day, but you are often operating and you are seeing to these cavities. Now, this peritoneum cavity is coming over here. This is the posterior cul de sac. This is dropping deep in between the uterus and the rectum. Am I right or wrong?
Right.
But what I mean by anteriorly, anterior cul de sac is not deep, but it is shallow. But
fine. That is
the catch. No. Listen. But here, the peritoneum is moving up and going this way. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, this space of raises is not having any connection. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Then, no way the fluid will get into the space of Ramsey's, even if you are having very, very severe fluid in peritoneal cavity. Am I right or wrong now?
Right, sir, right. Got it.
Now, if this is the space of Ramsey's, and if you are seeing a fluid in space of Ramsey's, what can be the cause?
Okay.
Right.
VVF. It could be VVF.
It can be a simple post-operative case or a trauma. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, how this all is reflecting on ultrasound? See, this is the diagram which we were just discussing, and this is the ultrasound picture. Now, if I will show you directly this ultrasound picture, if I will show you patients. Believe me, you will never learn ultrasound. Ultrasound is all about the correlation of your knowledge with the monitor, whatever you are seeing. Now, Dr. Anjana, quickly tell me, is this space of Ramsey's here, yes or no?
Sorry, I couldn't hear.
Is this space of Ramsey's, yes or no?
Which one?
Should I draw on this?
Yeah. Below the bladder, it is the space of Ramsey's.
Right. So this is not here. Let me take the pen now. This is space of Ramsey's. Yes or no? Dr. Anjana, this way we are teaching. Yes or no? No. Space of Ramsey's is over here. So if you see a fluid over here, this is not anterior cul de sac, but this is space of Ramsey's. Now, this is anterior cul de sac, which is over here. This is over here. Now, the posterior cul de sac is here. Now, the point is anterior cul de sac exactly in front of the posterior cul de sac? The answer is no. It is not actually here. It is higher over here. Because the peritoneum is not coming deep anteriorly, but posteriorly it is coming deep. So here comes the ultrasound picture, which you can now make out. Why is anterior cul de sac, why is posterior cul de sac, and why is the space of Ramsey's? So this is the anterior cul de sac over here. Posterior cul de sac is going deep because peritoneum is deep over here and shallow over here. And this is the space of Ramsey's over here. So this way the ultrasound has to be done. First, you have to clear your anatomy, not whole of the anatomy, but whatever you need for this ultrasound, that should be crystal clear to you. Now, this is the anterior cul de sac over here, and posterior cul de sac is over here, and this is the space of Ramsey's over here. So these were the pelvic spaces.